And a happy new year.
Wait, not yet.
What's the 12 days song?
On the first day of KI Live. Bette Masterson gave to me.
Welcome, everybody. This is our final and best, I am sure, KI Live of the year.
It hasn't even happened yet, and it's totally the best.
It's already amazing. We spent so much time on all of the bling bling here, thanks to Professor Falmea, and just decorating the office a little bit and the KI Live studio here at KingsIsle with all of you in the community. My name is Spark in Wizard, aka Bette Masterson in Pirate, and I am with Professor Falmea
in both games. And we have Decius.
Hello.
Manning the Twitch and all that stuff over there. And then we have Kaylee joining us.
Hey. Kaylee is helping out all the tweeting.
She's all the Twitters.
All the Twitters. And you all can see a little bit of that in our window right here.
Yeah, right.
On our second camera
there.
View that shows
there.
Our studio room here.
Yeah.
Give you a little bit more of a view. Also, a very tiny sneak peek of the screenshots that you all sent in. Thank you for all of those. They are playing
There's
on the monitor
some
right now.
Really great ones this month. It's awesome.
Yeah, very
it's
nice and festive.
Super awesome.
So we have a few things here.
What do we got going on today?
We've got news and so many things. We wanted to really like this is the last KI Live, so we wanted to just
do it up.
And mention a few things about the last few months and what we've done for the games, what we put into Wizard and Pirate, and what you have produced in the community on events and contests.
Yeah.
Just like
There's
I could go on for
of,
hours.
I know. We could do a whole KI Live on
just on that.
Like, just on that because it's you guys are awesome.
Yeah. We have we're really happy with all the feedback that you've provided for a lot of the things that we put in the games as well, and so thank you for that. Just to get that right off the bat,
we
also have a special guest on the show.
We do have a special guest.
He has not been on KI Live.
No.
In fact, I'm not sure he has ever shown his presence in a video before.
I don't believe so. I believe he does the Twitters, though, right?
Oh, yes. There's a clue. He is very active on the Twitters.
Mm-hmm.
So we are very happy to have him on the show today to show some of his work. Literally show some of his work.
Yes.
There's another clue
It'll
for
be
you.
Interesting to see if anybody guesses it.
We'll
there.
See.
You know,
well, if you can guess who it is that we are going to present on the show.
But we'll announce it in a little bit when we bring him in.
And then we also have a couple of things. Since it's also the end of the year, I wanted to take another opportunity to let all of you know to please check your accounts, make sure they're secure, make sure
Don't share your passwords.
Don't share your passwords with us either. We will never, ever ask for it.
Don't need to. If it's us, we can get into your account when you ask us to without sharing your passwords.
Yeah, we will take care of any...
Let me fix it, but I need your password. They're not us.
Yeah.
Not us.
We will help you out. Just let us know, whether it's a support thing or a community thing. But we want you and your accounts to be safe, as always. So
and
please just be aware of that.
Santa is watching you, even though it's not Thanksgiving yet. Santa is watching you, and be nice in Twitter, be nice in Twitch chat, be nice in game. Just be nice. Be excellent.
Or you get coal. You can get coal in the game, I think.
Yeah,
technically.
But in the game, you kind of want coal. That is not a reason to be mean. Krampus will not give you coal if you're mean.
And then, just be friendly to everybody. Be nice. If there's a new player, this will, I see this almost all the time when I'm in the game. There is someone who I recognize, and they are helping out a new player that has just joined the game and are not sure how to play.
Today, actually, when I was getting set up, I heard somebody in chat say, "I'm new. I haven't played in a long time. Can anybody help me?" And then somebody came over and said, "Yeah, okay, I would." Like, I just saw that happen.
It was cool.
It was nice. I know it happens all the time, but it's really cool to just, see it today.
It is not Tony. So that guess, one down. And
we should have Tony on. But
we should.
More guests next year. We will.
We also had a lot of dev diaries and other videos. We had, asking the community, what... We really want to know for 2020, and keep this in mind, and let me know what your ideas are for videos that we produce that you want.
We've done a lot more in 2019. We started Dev Diaries the year before, but we really kind of stepped it up. We've done some developer live streams. We've done more videos. And we actually have planned to start in 2020 new tutorial videos, like 2 to 4 minute tutorials on just either new things or things that might need an explanation. The first one we're planning on, which probably will be early 2020, will be on spellments and the spell writing system. We've actually kind of written out a script and are looking at getting it produced right now.
And that's a relatively, you know, that's a new system, but if you guys like how we produce these videos, please let us know, because we want to go back and cover other things, especially for new players.
Yeah, it could be newer stuff. It could be even older stuff that you think, this would have been nice to know when I was a new wizard.
Yeah.
It would have been helpful if I had videos to watch.
So, you know, it's like 2 to 3 minute long videos where we're playing the game, but we're not on the screen. We're just voicing over. Now, this is where you go and click on the Spellements tab. And if you then want to, you know, it's kind of instructional. And, you know, if you beat us to the punch and you produce some really cool videos that are like that too, great. I mean, that's fantastic. Yeah. We'll share those as well. We have a... Is it
people are hearing the bloops every time we get a message. So
yeah.
That's you.
It's going pretty close.
I don't know how to turn them off. Let's see here. Okay. So I have like 15 different things here that help to monitor our activities. And one of those is a little bloop you're probably getting. That is the audio of our chat, our internal chat. And I'm going to mention a very important community announcement. If you want to explore the options there. So we have made a few announcements on this already. It's a community event that is going to be at the PAX South 2020 show this coming January. Mm-hmm. January 16th through the 19th is the show. We will have a few of us at KingsIsle at the show. We're going to be attending, walking around, meeting a lot of the community members. But we also have plans to participate in the Dual Circle 5th anniversary event, the party they have at Thursday, January 16th.
Yes.
So Thursday evening on January 16th, I think
this
I have that.
This will be really cool because it'll be our first, it'll be a KI Live, which isn't an official KingsIsle KI Live. We'll be broadcasting it on our official channels, but it will be run by Dual Circle.
Yeah, so they're going to
have... It's totally his show.
They're going to have a lot at the event. They're going to have all sorts of things for anyone who happens to attend PAX South. Registration is open right now. It is free.
Looks pretty cool, yeah.
And then, like you said, we'll have a live stream that is handled by Dual Circle. We are kind of guests on the show.
Yeah.
And we're really excited with that because it's going to be different. It's going to be different than you're used to. And we'll see, you know, how it goes, and we are really just looking forward to meeting more community members.
We have someone that somehow has the same name as we do, in the chat right now.
Really?
The
exact same name?
People's passwords.
Okay.
Oh, no.
In the Twitch chat?
Yes.
Can you get rid of it? Can you just mute it?
Yeah, don't
something?
Do that, guys.
Yeah, that's not cool. I didn't know you could have the exact same name.
I didn't either.
Yeah, just...
Yeah, they caught me. Yes, we caught you.
So just take care of that.
I'm working.
If you have any questions about how to register and join the Dual Circle Party or attend PAX South that is here in Texas, please look at the news announcements that we have up on our blog. We have one up on KingsIsle blog. We all go to dualcircle.com/PAX South 2020. And there's all the details there on what Dual Circle has plans. I just gave you a quick overview. I could spend another live stream talking about that cool event.
There's a lot planned. It'll be really awesome.
So if there's anything specific to their evening party, ask Dual Circle. They'll be able to provide details for you. But we really hope you're going to be able to attend. And then moving on, we have Wizard 101 News.
Wizard News! So we had a lot going on the last month. We had our fall update, which had a lot of stuff. We had Wizard City Underground was the big headliner, which had new quests, new bosses to fight, and lots of cool new story. Like,
and I hear a community were able to finally find Landscaper Doug.
Yes. Yes.
Like, he was lost for a long time.
Finally
I was really worried about him.
Finally figured out where Landscaper Doug was. I mean, he got on milk cartons. People were having vigils for him. It was just a sad state of affairs. But now he's found, and we found out a lot more about, you know, there's some stuff in Wizard City. Like, going underground there was a lot that tied back into previous story, like in Dragonspire and Wizard City and other places. So,
yeah, there's a lot of community who brought up like Dragonspire and some themes in there.
Yes.
And so that was really cool to see that. And I learned a little bit about the history of Wizard 101 from what the community was talking about.
Very nice. Very nice. Yeah. So we had that. And of course, there's cool new gear. And we had the new spells, the spellaments, the spell writing. We're super excited about that. And there's lots more planned there.
And one of my favorite here on
the backpack butler.
Yes.
The backpack butler. So for anybody who doesn't have one yet, go get one. You can see anything that's on your wizard, and you can look and find out where it is. You might have this pet that you've not been able to find, and it's in your wizard's watchtower in the attic, and you haven't looked there forever. So it's really exciting.
Steaming hot chocolate. Actually, it's not really, it's just coffee, but, you know.
Oh, and somebody asked me what kind of tea I saw. It was, mint tea.
We have a lot of that here.
Yeah, we do. Mint tea is good. I drink a lot of mint tea. What else did we have? Castle magic. We had a couple new spells. I think one was hiding the PvP sigil, and a whole bunch of new spell effects, and I think there was one spell, but I'm spacing what that was. Sorry, guys. Events. We had some new Beast Moon Hunt beast forms that everybody got a chance to try out on test. We had a new map, one that went up and down and all over, and it was
fun. That one's you can get lost in there, be careful. There's a lot of like strategic, like how to get to the next circles, and so it's
what they call map mastery. I have to say, when I first started the map, I'm like, I don't like this map at all, and then after playing it every day for a while, I'm like, I like this map. I know my way around, and some people don't.
You figure out the strategies, and like, there's certain like, oh, I can actually do this now and get over here a little bit quicker. By the way, let us know in Twitch chat what your favorite Beast Moon form is.
Yes.
I'd be curious to know.
Man, it's toss up between that fire elf and the balance wolf warrior. Yeah, the balance wolf warrior.
I don't know what my favorite is. I tend to go like
Stormcraft.
Stormcraft?
Which one is it?
Yeah. Mine. Stormcraft.
Kaylee?
I like the Fire Elf.
Fire Elf.
Yeah, Fire Elf's good.
Good combos with that one.
I'm kind of the person like
when
you
1-2 punch mm-hmm. where yeah.
Well, you ask me like
yeah. Yeah, no, I know.
Okay, so if I ask like what's your favorite movie? You have two possibilities, and you all know what I'm talking about, I'm sure. You usually have one possibility being the movie itself is good. Like I the story and everything is just like that is why it's good. And then the second possibility is I like that person in there. They're either a good actor or they're good looking or what have you. And so I'm kind of that latter one where it's like maybe it's not a great movie, but oh, that person's in there, so I'm gonna watch it.
All right, what's your favorite story?
Well, what's
your favorite Beast Moon form?
Oh, well, anything anything with wolves, or that looks strong.
So the balance like, wolf
which is
warrior,
like half
the,
of them.
Maybe the storm
yeah,
wolf
like
warrior.
Of
both of those are
yeah.
good.
Yeah.
All right. So we did that. We had we changed up the decathlon. We took it up to 30. We took it up to 30.
Has anyone gotten to all 30?
Yeah, I saw people on test get up to 30.
I saw two.
Two?
Really? Wow.
Well, if we saw two, I'm sure there's more people that got up there. It was challenging. It was really challenging to get all the way up there. And at the top, you fight your professor. That was the big secret, but we've already revealed it, so I won't pretend. And we have endurance mode now, which means you get in at floor one and you go as far as you can instead of stopping at floor three and then jumping out and doing it again. It's a totally different tactic.
That's kind of
so,
nice. Yeah, a little more convenient.
And it's just it's a different way to play, so it's super fun. This one's yours. Community contest.
Oh yeah. So as we were coming up with what we were going to talk about, I'm always like thinking, what has the community done? And so I just wanted to give a shout out that all of the contests, the events, some of the, you know, like the Beast Moon event, when we have the Beast Moon running or the decathlon, even when you're challenging yourself going up the tower, all of those announcements and articles, just a shout out that's awesome, that we love seeing those. Happy to always share those announcements and participate in any of the actual events in the game. Please invite us. Let us know if you have something happening on a weekend, even, and we'll see if we can attend.
Yeah, we love community events. We love participating in them when we can or hyping them.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of that, I almost missed one thing here. Ew. Also, with Dual Circle, go to dualcircle.com/clash. They have, just like last year, they had their 5th anniversary Clash tournament in mid-December. So I believe signups are still open for that. But go ahead and check it out and let us know if you're going to participate.
And the last thing was we made some changes to PvP. A couple spell tweaks that we hope will make PvP a little more fun and fair for everybody. And we'll continue to monitor how those go. And we actually looked at the win-loss rates really recently, and they're kind of getting a little closer for each class, so for each school, so we like that, and we're gonna see if we can keep tweaking stuff.
Oh,
and that's pretty much it.
Yeah, an amazing amount of stuff, and that was just these last few months.
Just the highlights, yeah.
Another thing regarding tweaking, we are tweaking how we are putting out the newsletters for the end of the year.
Mm-hmm.
They're monthly, and that will continue, but we wanted to make the holidays newsletters of December and January a little more meaningful, a little bit more, you know, packed with the latest stuff, where you don't have to wait for like the Januaries, for example, to hear about what came out in mid-December, because we put out the December one in the first week of December, and then right after that, of course, was the 12 Days of the Spiral or what have you. So we want to make sure that the newsletters cover the recent news as much as possible, because there's so much happening in December. Events for you guys. So we are consolidating December, January into one, and it'll be released sometime in mid-December.
All right. Sounds good.
Oh, and one for each game. Not literally one, but one wizard and one pirate.
So what else do we have here? We have the Wizards in the Underground and other content now live. Oh, that's wrapped up in there. But the teaser videos. Oh my gosh, I have to talk about those.
Oh, yeah.
They were so good.
We'll do more of those. Maybe we have something else on test.
We did the Sinbad one, and then we did these. I really appreciated the team putting them together.
Yeah.
When I saw them, I had to go high five everybody.
Yeah, so we're gonna we're gonna have more videos of all sorts of things next year. It's gonna be fun.
And we have the veterans theme music scroll and music player. Or wait, the music player was for pirate. We'll get to that. Harvest Hand is back. Abracadoodle 202.
Yeah. Average Doodle is, we actually have one coming up. I think that actually is supposed to be 202. But we released 201, and I was getting ahead of myself there a little bit. But
sorry,
Jeff Tony, who is not also on the show, but another one that we should have on the show, is working on the next
episode. We've had him on the show before.
I thought he was a long time ago. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we'll bring him back as well.
Yeah, we'll try to get him back.
But you guys are on the right, you're in the right direction.
Mm-hmm.
What else we have? So much news. We're going to talk about Pirate News here shortly. We're going to get into Wizard 101 gameplay and Pirate 101 gameplay. There's just so much to talk about in the beginning. And I think,
next month.
That's right.
Next month.
I said one live stream KI Live, but there's also the community live streams that I've been doing a few times this year. I want to do more of those next year, where it's just me and you guys. One-on-one. Me and you guys playing one of the games.
No.
Nobody else is invited. Mm-mm. Sorry about that.
That's okay.
But, you know, we have our own developer
live streams that we do, and we'll probably do. We're talking about doing them more often next year, so. I'll still invite you.
Okay. That'd be nice. But I like hanging out with the community, so I can do my community live stream. That's fine. You don't have to invite me. That's okay. So we have...
I'm nice, so I'll invite you. You don't have to show up, but...
So we have... possibly one more December live stream, actually, which will be the community live stream. And I want to continue my Mushu Wizard 101 Fire Wizard.
You should.
We're going to pick up there where we left off.
Mushu's a very cool place.
Yeah, we just got into it last live stream.
It's one of my favorites.
And you know, only 1 hour that we have on these takes, you know, longer to get through some of these areas. So
sure enough.
Next month, we will run one of those. And
we got a Twitter poll.
Twitter polls. Are we ready for Twitter polls?
We are.
Excellent. So we have a Twitter poll. You are pinned down during an intense snowball fight and need some last-minute assistance. This describes like every snowball fight I've been in. Which Spiral resident do you recruit to turn the tide of the battle?
Oh, man.
Hashtag KI Live. Your well, hashtag KLive will have the poll. Put mm-hmm. your choice in for the poll, and then later on in the show, we will revisit that poll to see which one was most preferred.
All right. We have Prospector Zeke.
We can mention. Yeah.
We have King Arturius, we have Mallory, and we have Belladonna Crisp. I know who I'm going with.
Mallory.
Yeah?
Sure.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Are you going to wait till the end to tell people who you're going for?
No, we just did.
Oh. We want to know what the community is going for. It doesn't matter. So
yeah, it doesn't matter what we're going for.
My audio is about 40 seconds behind real.
Oh. Lag! Time travel! There's like a pocket dimension over there by Decius, so.
If you're just joining us, this is our KI Live. Every month we have our KI Lives, developer live streams here at KingsIsle. Talks about Wizard 101 news, Pirate 101 news, play a little bit of the games, and some, you know, guests that come on once in a while. We're going to show screenshots that you've submitted, mm-hmm. holiday festive screenshots at the end of the show as well.
We have blinky lights.
Blinky lights, yeah. Nice, really quite comfortable hats on.
Yeah.
And just, you know, hanging out with you guys, having fun, celebrating the end of the year and all that we've accomplished in 2019 mm-hmm. and getting excited already for what's
2020.
Coming in 2020. Yep. We're going to hit the ground running in January.
Man, we've already hit the ground running over here on the MMO team. I just have to say, we got a lot going on already.
That reminds me of one thing. Where did our pens go?
Where did our pens go? Here's
I have
pen.
Something for you that I think the community is going to love. Mm. I can't talk about it just yet, but just, you know, came into the old noggin here, so stay tuned for
2020. I'm a little scared. I'm scared. Everybody, what's he writing down?
I think we have a good list of pirate news here. No.
How about you do that? I'll talk about the pirate news.
Okay.
So,
talking
about all the cool things we've done in the last couple months. We had 7th birthday. For the 7th birthday, we had our first simultaneous launch of a CCG booster pack in both games, the Pirate Nightmare pack, which, if you remember, had the charred companions, it had the Pocket Dutchman, and had the Macabre, which is fun to say, and also fun because it's a play on words for macaw, but macabre. And what else? Gear, weapons, all sorts of cool stuff. So that was fun. We had the new skeleton key bosses that have unlockable companions as well. We had FTUD. We went through and fixed the first time user difficulty through the first part of the game. We fixed nautical XP so that it was easier to level and more in line with levels. We had, what else? Quest difficulty. We went through and found some particularly annoying quests and made them more fun. Easier to get through. And we have new mounts. We had the carrier bat in October. We had the midnight owl in November. And there'll be a new one in December. And there's quite a few new ones that you haven't seen yet.
Ooh, more. Yay.
So yay. And the new enhanced elixirs, which we improved. We have a new tier of elixirs, which are better. So if it was like 10% to a stat, it's now 15% to a stat. They last longer. They last 3 hours instead of 1 hour. And then we have the hyper elixir, which is all the enhanced elixirs kind of smashed together, and it has 12 hours. So if you're going to have an epic day of playing pirate, get your hyper elixir and you can just be awesome. So I think that's pretty much it. We had the harvest items return. That was pretty cool. And
Puppet Pirates.
Puppet Pirates.
Yes.
Do we have Puppet Pirates?
We do.
Nice.
So Puppet Pirates number 85 was quite festive as well. Quite appropriate to the month here. And I'm gonna bring it up for you guys here
Oh, look at that.
There we go.
Look at that.
Number 85 here had I was glad that this one was chosen. So from Luella, apologies if I mispronounce that, Luella Ruby Flame.
Ruby Flame.
Just a general, sometimes when, this is a general quote, despite our differences, nothing connects us together like eating together.
Aw, that's true.
So it's a very nice quote.
So it's very nice to share a meal with people, especially, you know. Some of those scallywags there.
So these puppet pirates, if you all want to get involved in these monthly ones and see if your quote was chosen, we post these every month, mm-hmm. and usually around the beginning of the month, and then we will ask for quotes based on the scene. So in this case, you have Boochbeard and Gandry and others that are all in the scene, and you can choose whomever you want. Usually it's Boochbeard and Gandry, and you'll have a quote where it'll say Boochbeard, and then quote Boochbeard will say something, and then Gandry will respond, and then maybe Boochbeard will say something back. You know, you keep it pretty short, because we only can put so much into the poll, which then goes out about a week after we reveal the image. Mm-hmm. We collect most of the ones we can fit into the poll, let you guys vote on your favorite, and this is the one for number 85 that came up this month.
85, that's a lot.
Yeah, we've been several years now.
That's awesome. Yeah. Fantastic.
I mean, Abracadoodle 201, I mean, that's even longer. It's really impressive.
It's been a while.
You can see all of them, by the way. All the go to Puppet Pirate, go to facebook.com/pirate101, and you have the Pirate 101 game, and you have all the Puppet Pirates there in the images section, and mm-hmm. the same thing for facebook.com/wizard101. You go there, and you have a section for all the Abracadoodles, so you can go all the way back to the beginning. Same thing for just going to the website. There's a tab in the website menus that you can review the history of all of them as well.
So. Awesome. Very cool.
You know what? I'm getting antsy for gameplay here. But before that, just, you know, we have a few more things. Did we have one of the...
Yeah, we do.
We did.
Hey, Decius.
Yeah.
Decius? Do you want to do the Would You Rather?
Oh, sure.
Are you coming over with your mask or
no mask.
Okay. Mask,
would you rather have Starburst or M&M's?
M&M's.
Okay, that was an easy
would
one.
Would you rather have Skittles or Milky Way?
Skittles.
Ooh, that's a tough one.
No. So someone brought in all their leftover Halloween candy.
Yeah, so we have so much candy.
We're still eating.
So we're like,
it.
Wee!
All right. So my would you rather was would you rather play ship PvP in pirate?
Huh?
Against me. Batmasters, Falmea, or Kaylee. So, let me know. And whoever wins the poll will come play with you.
So if you wanted to play ship PvP against one of us,
yes.
Which one would you choose?
I mean, depending on how much time we have, we might all jump. Wait, what? What's going on? What is happening over there?
Me.
Well, that's fine.
Okay. And you can...
I won't be offended if I don't win this one.
And feel free to shout it out in Twitch chat if you're in Twitch chat as well. Which one you would prefer? We're curious to know.
Let's see, what do we got?
My name came up. That's not
Kaylee,
a good sign.
Falmea, Skittles, Milky Way.
Skittles.
I think they're answering all sorts of different questions.
All the Skittles. Let's
see, what else do we
have? Okay, we'll revisit that back.
Keep talking about it, and then Decius will proclaim a winner.
So we had talked about in the beginning of the show, if you're just joining us, KI Live here at KingsIsle.
Hello!
And we are just about to invite one special guest who's not been on the show yet to show you some of his work. And we are going to, here's another clue, we've made wallpapers out of his work.
Yes.
And shared it with the community.
Yes,
we'll do more of those in 2020.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I have a wallpaper on my screen. I think it was from
the
Valentine's
one. Yep,
there we go.
Ding, ding, ding.
That's the one.
It is.
So Adam Roush will be joining us here. I don't know if he's quickly drawing something special on the spot for us.
I don't know. We didn't ask him to, but that would be awesome if he just did.
We have actually a pre-question I want to kind of get out of the way, too. So
okay.
Do you mind if I ask this?
No, go for it.
This is from Kutonia. As we are ending yet another wonderful year of Wizard 101 and Pirate 101, what are one of the most amazing yet small things that you have seen in-game?
All right, well, for Wizard 101, everybody knows, I would hope, that I'm a big fan of the decathlon. I've said it a lot of times. And while it's been cool to see during the events, like that area near Argleston, just populated with people, just getting in, playing, and talking, watching people just rally around people like Alexander Owl or other people who were trying to get at the top of the leaderboards and support them. Like, at first, the first couple times with the community effort when the leaderboards were there and people were kind of picking their champions, like, okay, I'm going to get you treasure cards. I'm going to help you get gold. I'm going to help you guys get to the top. That was pretty cool. And shout out to kind of both games, just watching people team up. and helping each other. It makes me feel so good when I see things like I saw earlier with somebody like, hey, I haven't played this game in a while. Can anybody help me? And people are like, yeah, sure. Come on, let's go. That's the coolest thing, you guys. And we have the best communities because there's people that are always willing to help. And
yeah, and that's one. That was one of the things I was going to mention for Pirate 101, especially is we have seen more activity with you guys recently over the last year, just engaging in your PvP events, and really it's for all these. I guess that's not a small thing. That's a pretty big thing when we see more activity from the community. That's just engaging with each other. So
I didn't want to say that it was a small thing, but it was just one of those things that okay. Yeah. Well, heartwarming, warms the heart.
With Wizard 101, I will say that the Backpack Butler is one of those, you could say, small things that makes a huge impact. You know, it's not like a new zone, or it's not a new entire event like, you know, the Beast Moon Hunt or the Decathlons. But the Backpack Butler, I'm a hoarder. I collect. I'll admit it.
Hi, my name is Spark, and I'm a hoarder.
You know, first to admit it. And anything that can help me to just organize. I just love organ. Like on the weekends, I'll just go in any game, and if it has any sort of I need to sort some stuff and clean it up a little bit, I'll just spend the entire weekend just doing that. But that's me. So I don't know if any of you are like that, where it's just like I just want to organize.
Lots of people saying the butler is amazing,
or just finding things for that matter.
Yeah. And the new kiosk improvements are very helpful. Yeah, absolutely. That's being able to search by talent is just so awesome.
Yeah. Did we get a response from him?
He said he was walking over.
Okay.
All right.
Fashionably late.
Yeah, just has to make an entrance. I see how it is.
Well, we're gonna.
One of my favorite things that I've seen in game, by the way, is that whenever I go by the team up kiosk, there's always a line.
Oh yeah.
Like there's always a line there.
I hate lines.
Well, it's just the fact
it's a good line.
I know.
It's a good line. I hate lines too. But it's a good line.
Yeah, they help each other, while they're waiting. That's awesome.
It is fantastic. And while I can't spill the beans on much that we're doing 2020, I would say that's one thing that we're looking into is maybe a little quality of life and being friendly with each other.
So I'm curious. Some people in the Twitch chat are talking about the Backpack Butler. Now we brought it up.
Yeah.
And one said, I bought a Backpack Butler for each of my houses. So I'm curious to know how many Backpack Butlers everybody has, and thus maybe how many of their houses. So feel free to chat about that. Well, we have Adam. Hey, Adam.
Hey.
How's it
going? Hey, how's it going?
I'm sorry, we don't have an extra. I don't think we have an extra hat for him, but
no, I don't have an extra hat. I'm sorry, but we will give you a chair.
Are we gonna squeeze him in?
Yeah,
in the middle.
Let's squeeze you in.
There you go. Hey. So this is Adam Roush. Did I pronounce your last name correctly?
Roush.
Roush.
No, it's okay. No, everyone's. It's a common mistake.
No, I do this for fun with the community. You know, I misspell everybody or mispronounce everybody's name at first.
Yep.
Because
we'll just call you Mathieu.
Then it's a talking point. It's a discussion point. See, we're talking about it.
Gotcha.
Well, Adam here is one of our finest concept artists, I will say, in the company. And
he's amazing.
I finally got him to come on the show and just show off some of his recent work. Some of you have seen it already in some of the wallpapers that we've created, and also the launcher screens for Wizard as well.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of those in there.
Mm-hmm.
And you've been here for well over a year, year and a half now.
Mm-hmm.
So there's been a lot that you've been working on, and I have a folder here of some of the art that you've created that we were going to show.
Yeah.
I don't know if we want to do questions first, perhaps.
Up to you.
Just kind of ask him and some of the questions I know the community wants to know now that you know that Adam is on the show here.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things I want to ask. Oh, is it?
Scoot up a little more.
Oh, yeah.
Nope.
For the mic. Yeah, so we can get you for the mic here.
Gotcha.
I can barely hear you.
I'll bring. Was that all just right. Barely for me, too? Or?
No, just.
Okay. All right. So don't forget.
I'll talk louder.
You can. This is your one opportunity to shout at the community. So
gotcha.
Please feel free.
Hello.
So what's your favorite thing about being a concept artist?
Honestly, it's just creating the content, just looking at different. Basically, just coming up with the creative solutions to our problems. Like if we need to make a cute pet or a scary monster, that's kind of my whole thing, just to create.
So you get the information of, okay, I know I got to create this. Like,
yeah.
the design team tells you,
mm-hmm.
and we have this monster.
Yeah.
It's going to be this rough size, perhaps,
mm-hmm.
and it's going to be ugly, or it's going to be scary looking, or ghostly looking, or whatever the parameters are.
Yeah.
They give you some general ideas, and then
mm-hmm.
and then you just like, okay, now I'm going to go to work and
yeah.
craft it, and then you
mm-hmm.
create like a sketch, then you share it with the team and go, okay, is this in the right direction, or you just go ahead and create the whole thing?
Usually I'll do a few different sketches, a few different design directions. So like the Devourer, for example, which is that big scary creature we have.
The community knows about the Devourer.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
So with that one, a whole bunch of different sketches, looked at a lot of H.P. Lovecraft, Aliens, Predator, just things with
big,
scary
see that, yeah.
details and things like that. And I made like 5 or 6, show those to the art director, show those to the team. They'll be like, we like this, we don't like this thing, don't like that part of this one, but we like this. And, you know, maybe I'll create a final sketch that's a whole bunch of different bits and pieces from all the various concepts and put those together and then paint that.
Oh, nice. So there's a lot of collaboration.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone at the company collaborates to, you know, it's not just a one-man show. We're always discussing, how does these things look?
Yeah.
And
yeah, it's always a team effort, for
yep.
sure.
And especially once it gets on test realm, you know, we're looking at the community feedback, too.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, the stuff we should, I didn't ask about your Twitter page, but Adam has a Twitter page. I'm assuming you're not afraid to share that because you do post about it. So what is the Twitter page?
It's just Adam Roush 2.
Adam Roush 2.
The number 2.
Number 2.
At the end.
So we retweet a lot of his work if we see a concept piece that you're putting on your Twitter page.
Yep.
I'll go ahead and retweet that on the Wizard page as well. And so you'll see those there. And go ahead and like his page. And follow it, because he has a lot of great stuff that he's posting there on a regular basis.
Definitely.
Out right now.
Oh,
awesome.
Right. So, of all of the art that we have, like a handful of pictures or
mm-hmm.
sketches or art pieces. There's a variety here that we're going to show in a minute.
Mm-hmm.
Keep in mind which one's your favorite, because I don't know if you all know it offhand, but when it comes up, mention which one's your favorite, because the community I know is curious to know what you know.
Okay.
What's the one you really love?
Right.
So, is there one that's been more challenging than others?
Ooh, that's a good question.
So the Great Below House, the one with the undersea enchantment, that one was a ton of work. That one, anytime I've ever had to do a world or a house, it's easily the most difficult thing. There's just so much to do. There's so many bits and pieces, things you have to pay attention to.
So you mean like this one?
Yep.
Oh,
like that one?
There.
Like that one.
All
exactly
right,
like that one.
That's detailed.
I tell you, it worked out because it's one of my favorites. So,
just
wanted to say good job on that one, even though it was challenging.
Thanks. You got both owls at your house?
Do I have both owls at my house? I'm. Oh, sure enough. Look at that. I have. If you go to me right now, if you're my friend, I'm in my house. I'll come hang out later.
We switched over to the background of Pirate. Cool.
Yeah.
How'd that happen?
Pirate's been up.
Excellent.
Yeah.
So I don't know where we're hanging out in Pirate right now. It's somewhere in
We are
Skull
hanging
Island.
Out just in the middle of, you know, middle Skull Island, and just right where, you know, you port back in. And I don't know what realm I'm on. I can check. Well, you know what? Everybody's found me, so that's fine.
Yeah.
With these KI lives, we always play a little bit of Wizard, a little bit of Pirate,
okay.
mm-hmm.
you know. So we have news and we have gameplay, and once in a while, when somebody is brave enough to join us on the live stream, then they'll show us some things too.
So I've often said that if I could have another job in the company and the talent to go along with it, because I don't, it would be a concept artist, because I really respect how you're able to take words and make pictures out of them. I think it's the coolest thing. So if you had to do something else besides concept art, what would you do?
I would love to be an animator. I actually studied animation, like 3D animation, the fundamentals and all that stuff in college. Never really took it, you know, to a career standpoint, but I geek out over it a ton. Like, anytime there's a new animated movie coming out, I'm like, I'm going to watch that.
Cool.
And I'm going to scrub through it frame by frame, see all those different... see how they do and their acting choices and all that stuff.
I'm trying to think of some of the recent ones. One just came out. drawn a blank.
Frozen?
Yes. Yes, Frozen.
I know
too.
That one came out.
I'm like, I'm all I'm thinking in my mind is,
did you freeze
it,
up?
Actually,
did you freeze up?
Well, double froze up because yep. All I have in my mind now is Let It Snow. Which
did your brain just
it.
Let it go?
It just let you know it's
okay,
just let it go.
I'm sorry. I'll just show myself out.
I liked it. I really liked it.
All right. Okay.
That's good. Okay. Good. Review time.
I have one fan over there. That's good. This is nice. Good. All right.
Yep. I think we went through all the questions.
Yeah. Do you want to talk about anything else?
You can go now.
Or do you want to just.
We have a Twitter question.
Oh, we do. Twitter question. Ooh.
Someone wants to know Zacky Poo is the name.
Oh, Zacky Poo.
What was the first sketch you made for Wizard 101?
Oh, wow. Going back.
See, I think the first ones were I was doing furniture for the Arrow Dwarves. Just like first day, trying to acclimate to the style of Wizard and get a good feel for how I should draw and paint and design and looking at all of the past concepts and all that stuff. So, yep. I think it was actually a box. Just a simple box with some simple design on top of it.
Way more.
Nothing too flashy.
But, you know, the question, what else would you do in the company if you could? Mm-hmm. I'll tell you what else I wouldn't probably do is
what wouldn't you do?
What you're doing, because I do not have the gift for what you do, and it's,
I don't either.
Like,
I want to
like I can imagine, like, if I could just see, you know, the vision before me of what I could draw, I could just draw over it. I suspect that's part of the secret. I don't know if that's true or not. But I can't draw anything to save myself,
okay,
which is,
man,
probably,
you
know.
You can learn. It's easy.
Yeah, that's what they all say.
Just,
but you
just
know
like
what?
10 to 15 years of learning, and then you'll
then you'll
be okay.
Just 10 to 15 years.
So there is a little bit of learning with it, too. Okay, good to know. All right, well.
That's saying that you have to do something for 10,000 hours or whatever to be good at it.
Yeah.
You
could just do it as a hobby, just on the side, just
yeah,
on little stick figures.
Yeah, okay, I'll start with that.
I doodle for fun, but that's all. Yeah. That's all that's...
Jeff Tony, we'll get him on. Maybe he can doodle.
Maybe, yeah.
A little doodle art class on KI Live. All right, let's show some of your art.
Yeah, sure. For sure.
Okay, now I believe these are in order. So when you see them, just go ahead and like launch into, whatever it is, and share the story. And this next one is not it, so don't be frightened. This is not yours, but I will switch it over to yours. There we go.
Ooh, yeah, that looks
okay.
Familiar.
So this is the Devourer, isn't it?
Yep.
Okay. I was so excited to actually get it on this one, so I wanted to mention it.
I was going to say that's actually like my favorite concept I've done so
is
far.
It?
Nice.
You know, I like monsters and scary things, and you know, with this one here, it was like make it scary but not too scary. Don't want to frighten everybody. But yeah, like, you know, with the alien and the predator, you know, it's got both jaws. I had originally another concept where I had the little, you know, hand, the little jaw inside the jaw.
Oh, the little thing that pops out.
Pops out, and you're like, that's a little too close. But yeah, it was really fun to do this one. And one of my favorite things to do when I get to do concepts is, paint. Painting things and trying to really, like, push the painting. So, like, on this piece, if anyone is, you know, looking at it, the lower jaw, there's a little bit of translucency in the skin there. So it's like, you know, getting to paint little tiny things like that.
Very nice.
Makes me
that's
very
really
happy.
Cool.
All right, and then the next one here, as it loads, there we go.
So this is the mermaid gear.
What do we call this sort of presentation of the, you know, the different angles of the character?
So this is called a model sheet, and it just shows you like the male and female, front and back, side, and some little details.
Actually, it's not showing up the whole way, but there's...
Yeah, we're missing a little bit here, guys. I mean, you get the idea.
You get the gist, yeah.
I think I can maybe move it over as he's talking about it.
But yeah, just it's for the modelers so that they have a good understanding of what they need to model and how it should look, and like the ideas that I'm having behind them. You know, they add their own flair to it, the modelers, which is, you know, usually makes my... I think it looks better usually when they take it and they add that wizard style because they've been doing it for, you know, so long that they can be like, this is a good detail, but it, you know, doesn't make sense necessarily in game. So I think they like downplayed a little bit of the flaps on the boots there a little bit. Maybe there's just one instead of two. But yeah, it's just
get the idea.
Gets the idea down so that they can model it as close as they can.
In some cases, they might be like, oh, well, if we do that, it's going to clip into this and that.
Yeah.
Or like the on the chest plate there, some of the fine details, a little bit too fine. We can't get all of the details, so sometimes we have to pare it down a little
bit. But it's always good to start with all the details and pare it down, for sure.
Yep. Jelly Quinn says, I love the Enchanted Undersea bundle.
Yes.
I plan. They don't even have it yet, and they love it. Awesome.
Yeah.
Thanks.
It's really cool.
So cool.
It's really cool.
And this one, my favorite.
The adorable griffin.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you had anything you wanted to. Any
it's
story about
it's
it?
Adorable.
It's just adorable.
It's adorable.
Yep. All right, moving on. And this one, actually, you know what? This might be my favorite because I love little village scenes like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is the. What is this one called? The fairy tale.
Fairy tale farm.
Fairy tale farm.
I always hear the working name, so I don't remember what they are. I know it's like the Fairy Tale Farm. I don't remember if that's the actual name.
Could we make this into a wallpaper? We could do that,
yeah,
can we?
Easily.
Okay, guys,
that's
wallpaper.
That's really cool. Yeah, I like.
tentatively.
I'm just that little like town scene over there.
Yeah,
so
if
you want
to live up to your expectations, I'll just hit print screen real quick and we'll send it back.
Done.
Well, want it in a 4:3 aspect ratio, which is what we're at the moment.
Perfect.
Here. I keep forgetting about that.
Done.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Oh, here's another one of those.
So this is one of the. What is this one? Catacombs.
Crusader?
Crusader.
Female Crusader?
Female Crusader. I think she's the upgraded one. I could be wrong. But yeah, this one here, just same thing, model sheet. And I actually have been learning a lot of 3D software this year, and that's what I did with the battle axe to get those other views.
Oh, neat.
The same goes with like the Devourer, just getting like the basic structure and all the detail. It's actually a little bit easier to do some of these concepts in 3D than it is 2D. It's just adding to my arsenal of
repertoire
of skills.
Yeah,
it
that's
makes things a little bit easier. Some things faster, like I did with the Great Below House. But I was super new to the idea of using 3D software to make stuff. So, you know, it's not quite as good. I think whoever did the environment modeling after the fact did a much better job of getting that wizard style and getting the detail in there. So.
What's the software you use?
Right now, I'm just using 3D Coat because it's super easy.
3D Coat? Okay.
ZBrush is a little bit more advanced, but it's also harder to learn, harder to understand.
So I should start with Z. What was it, Z Coat?
3D Coat?
3D Coat.
All of the modelers here use it to actually paint the models for the game, but you can sculpt in it, and you can do a lot of other things in it. So.
Neat.
Yep.
Nice. All right, and I think we have one or two more here. Ah, yes.
Oh, the stage coach.
Yeah, this might be my favorite mount.
The evil wagon.
The evil wagon. Again, I use a lot of 3D to get the basic structure down, but like the final in-game model is almost one-to-one in terms of detail. So, yeah this one came
really
out.
Yeah, it's really similar.
Awesome.
Yeah, that's very cool.
Mm-hmm.
And last but surely not least, I think this was one you wanted in here, right?
Yeah. Anyway. So,
yeah, not only do you do concepts for us, you make our posters that we put in GameStop or anywhere else that we do promos, so.
Yeah, this is one of those ultra-wide, I think it was a banner in GameStop's.
Yeah, it's a banner that's at the top of, like, the game cards or something like that, or below some retail space.
Yep. Basically just taking a lot of the concepts I did and putting them into an illustration to advertise our new,
and bundle.
Bundle card.
Yeah.
Very cool. Oh, yeah.
Oh, this one. This maybe shouldn't be on here. This is something new that we have.
Oh, yeah. I was going to ask you if we should have had this on here or not.
No, it's okay. Ooh. This is, we won't say what it is, but this is concept artwork for something that's coming out soon next year.
So it's not in the game yet. People have not seen this at all in any shape or form.
It is not available in game yet.
Oh.
So, yeah, sneak peek right here.
Okay, well, we can't talk about it, so
we
moving
won't
on,
talk
I guess.
About that one, so. All
right.
What else do we got? Is that it?
That was I think I put that at the end.
Okay.
Purposely at the end.
I see how it goes.
All right, well, thank you, Adam, very much for being on the show.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Of course.
Fun.
And we'll maybe see you on a future KI Live in 2020 or 20 whenever.
Okay, sounds good.
Thanks.
Yeah, thanks again.
And I think now we can roll that over. Thanks, Adam.
Yep.
Shall we play some games?
Let's play some games here.
Let's play some games here.
Okay. We have Wizard 101 gameplay, I think, first, yes?
Yes.
And you had a plan
for that
one.
I do. So because we're running low on time, I think I'm going to spend 10 minutes in Wizard and 10 minutes in Pirate. So for 10 minutes in Wizard, I'm going to start...
Please make it the Wizard Underground.
Yes, that's what we're doing.
Excellent.
So whoever's coming with me. Oh, look at the balloons.
Yay. Oh, let's move it over to see. So we, can we have that done again? There we go.
That's what we're doing. We're going to go to the Wizard City Underground. Whoever's coming in with me, you'll probably have to kind of help. I've got spells. I've got some gear.
While you're playing, I can feed you candy.
So, we're going to go. Oh, wait. I think I actually marked it instead of... Well, we'll just run there.
And if you're just joining us, this is our monthly KI Lives. Last KI Live of 2019 here.
Yes.
I am Spark, and I have Professor Falmea with
me. Hello.
We also have Decius and Kaylee, who are both supporting us off camera. Although you can guys see them in the... Well, actually, you can't see them at the moment, but there's another camera on our main view. That you can see the rest of the studio.
Yes, indeedy.
I'm currently in second place.
Oh, really?
On the vote.
Oh, yeah?
So please, more people vote for me.
Who's in first?
You are.
Oh.
Or you could just double vote like you did last.
I can't. It's Twitter.
You just keep voting for yourself.
Oh, that's too bad.
Oh, no. You really want to play Decius because whoever you play is going to get defeated over and over.
We have a... By the way, everyone, we have questions that we have gathered and tips from all of you this past month. Thank you for that. Oh, yeah, sound, audio, music.
Okay, let us know if it's okay.
Yeah.
Let us know if it's okay.
Can't hear us? You know, if you don't want to hear us, then that's fine, I guess.
I tell you what, let's wait until we got some VO to do.
Thanks for coming, Wizard. Subterranean Sanitation Operations reports there's some kind of problem in the drains. I offered to check it out myself, but the sanitation boss claims that you are the only topsider he trusts to handle the matter. Will you help? Great! The boss is right below us waiting for you. You can use that manhole right there. Good luck!
Uh-oh. There we go. Okay. Man! Jump in here and... Okay. The boss.
Ah, salutations, wizard. Or is it scion of probably now? Irregardless. I am most grateful to have come in this, our hour of need. As you may know, we insects of the subterranean sanitation operations have used the drains to process topsider garbage for generations. Normally, we have no problem dealing with all manner of foul refuse. However, these are not normal times. At present, the trash is revolting. And I do not mean that the trash is malodorous. I mean, the trash has developed sentience, organized, and taken over the dump in a violent coup. Please, Sion, go conversate with the dump foreman and devise a plan to quash this trash monster rebellion before it spills over to Wizard City.
Yay. Okay, we have questions and tips to you. Should I ask one now?
Well,
Can we wait to get a little further?
I'll tell you what. We're going to get through the talkie parts, and then when I get into combat.
Sounds good.
Yeah! Right. Ooh, sorry. No offense, but your topside is a terrifying to look at. You must be the infamous scion of... The boss says your psionical razzmatazz is our best hope. First things first. We gotta figure out what's bringing the trash to life. If you preoccupy the trash monsters with some of that fancy spell slinging you do, I'll sneak around and see if I can find the root cause.
Okay. We're gonna go defeat trash. I'm gonna jump in... No, I'm not gonna jump in Stephen Golddreamers. I'm gonna see about going over here. Because he's doing his own thing. Here we go. Someone jump in and help me. Yeah, there we go. Okay. What do I got? Okay, I'm just gonna... You guys have to really defeat this. I'm gonna be answering questions.
Help
I'm barely. Falmea. I'm barely paying attention here. Yeah, you guys can... I'm sure you guys can beat these guys with like the back of your hand. Done it many times. Okay. What do we got? What do we got for questions and game? Ask me some things.
Ask you a question? All right. Well, from Genevieve Moongarden. I love the bear character in the underground. What was the inspiration?
So this one is kind of near and dear to our heart. So we loved him too. Hargrove was actually named, and kind of obviously he wasn't a bear, but kind of the look and the feel was modeled after Greg Hargrove, our first lead artist, who unfortunately passed away last year, and we wanted to honor him with a character that was exploring underneath Wizard City, which was the world that he helped definitely establish the visual style, and we thought that it was kind of, we were hoping that it was a fitting tribute to him, so.
That's nice. Hmm.
Yeah. So, a lot of times we'll be like, oh, we just thought about combining this and this, and this one was actually really special, so I wanted to talk about it.
Angus Goldvault asks, Spellaments are a great new idea, I agree. Although mm-hmm. still in its early stages, lots yes. of potential for. Mm-hmm. Will spellaments eventually be obtainable from gardening or crafting? Great question.
I will answer the first part of it. We have a bunch of new spellaments and spell upgrades through spell writing planned out for next year. I don't want to talk about exactly what they are, but oh, look at that. Music down? All right. And we want to spread them all over the game. The first way you were able to obtain them is obviously in the catacombs for the Daybreaker and Nightbringer. The next place you'll be able to obtain some of them is in CCG packs that are coming up soon. Sprinkled out there. And
soon.
Soon. DC looks stressed by me saying soon.
Don't. I'm stressed. What? No.
What? No. All right. Sorry, guys, like I said, you're going to have to carry me through this, because...
Oh, you're doing fine.
They're doing great. I've casted 2 wand spells, so...
I think we can tell which realm we are in. We are currently... Oh, my gosh, where'd it go? Does it not show on the screen?
Interesting. No, it doesn't. Because yeah, you can't switch. Like, you can't switch realms when you're in an instance like that.
Okay.
Well, it's okay. I messaged everyone.
Oh, thank you. Okay. Wait, what is it so I can say it over voice?
Is it Ambrose?
Ambrose.
Ambrose, I think we were in area 2.
So that was before you went into the
game. Yeah, we're check around in Ambrose. We're somewhere in there. Defeat the trash. Oh, wait, we have to talk to the dump foreman.
Hey, Hunter Dark Flame.
Hello!
Level 130, nice.
Alright, ooh.
Dump Foreman has something to say.
While you had them distracted, I was able to identify the cause of this rebellion.
So I can't tell.
Goo.
So just taking it best
or
guess.
Should I say, magical goo. There's a trickle of the enchanted goo coming out of that pipe over there. Whoever is responsible for this, you's gonna have to climb up the pipe and confront the source of the goo. Then we can figure out what to do with the remaining trash monsters.
Investigate the source of the magical goo. All right, guys. I've got my crew with me. This is cool.
Big TD64, the trash sheep has spoken.
The trash sheep has spoken.
Sorry, but the Alchemy Club meeting has been canceled. But hey, you look like a pretty advanced wizard. Mind giving us a hand? Please?
Ah yes, codes. We have a giveaway code for all of you at the end of the show, so stick around for that.
Okay. Let's go take out the trash, crew. Got Valerian Drake, Alexander L, and Victoria Thunder Shard. Hey, guess what? You know what? Let's just blade storm everybody. At least I can help a little bit. So
another question?
We got more questions.
Okay. We have one from Patrick Ravenbane. Out of all the holiday pets, all the pets.
Yes.
Which one is your favorite and why?
So you didn't specify what holiday, so I'm gonna say the Golden Sun. Because it's summer. If you're talking about winter holiday, the polar fox, because it's stinking cute. Nice. It is stinking cute. All right, Decius.
Yes.
What's your favorite pet? Holiday pet.
My favorite holiday pet?
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. I love all the pets.
That's such a Decius answer.
Does the eagle count? The I forget the exact name of it, but it has the American-looking eagle.
The patriotic eagle?
Patriotic eagle. Oh, that's true. Yeah. Never mind. I guess I like mounts more.
I don't know. Favorite one.
Is it like being asked to pick a favorite child? All right.
No, but that would be pretty easy.
Oh, would it? Okay.
Who do we got? What are you guys? Man, okay. I'm just gonna randomly hex one. That's what I'm gonna do.
DJ Moore is an elf person. And V Man says, my favorite pet will always be the snow.
More cat pets. There is a new cat in Wizard City Underground, and it's a tribute to one of our employees' pets that unfortunately left us a little too soon. So. There's a kitty that's in, I believe, actually, in this area. So
tip,
more cats.
Tips time. Stomach Spell says, if you bought a Beast Moon School seed recipe, plant it.
Yes.
They reach elder in under a day.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. With no needs or pets.
Yeah,
Pests.
So that was one of the things we were talking about when we did Beast Moon, is we wanted to get more people in the gardening system, but we wanted to kind of make it gardening light so that people got in and could see how cool plants are and maybe get inspired to garden some other plants. So.
And they'll also reward you with brand new Beast Moon items.
Yeah, the Beast Moon plants are really good. If you're into Beast Moon, they give you lots of stuff.
Including some good TC.
Mm-hmm.
For the decathlon, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Oh, look at that. I love this. They're just taking care of business while I'm gapping away.
Mm-hmm. Well, I have another question here from Snee432. Snee asks, is there any plan to re-release retired charity mounts, pets, like the fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-llama,
or the
meow-meow-meow-meow-meow-meow-meow? Yeah.
Well, last year we did release two of our previous charity mounts, and it's certainly not to say.
Wait, hold on. Are you Bartleby Scion? Awesome! Please, Scion, you've got to help my friends with the rest of the trash monsters!
All right, more trash, guys.
Help with the trash monsters.
We love the trash monsters. The team giggles about this.
Should we is it time for a poll update? Because we don't have I didn't note in the script, not that we're doing script, that,
Oh, we got a script. I couldn't do this
We have
script.
The results for it when we were going to mention
that. All right, so we'll brainstorm again. Hey, by the way, let me finish answering the question.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So it's not outside of the realm of possibility in the future, but this year we got something new. So stay tuned.
Twitter poll. So we
Twitter
have results
poll.
For the Twitter poll.
So yes, right now.
Can you hand me the pen? Who is
King Arturius?
King Arturius.
King Arturius with 40%.
Malori is in second with 27%.
Malori is in second with 27%. Prospector Zeke with 21%.
And poor Belladonna is in last with 10%.
No, Belladonna with 10.
She does run the mysterious school, the Pigswick school, and they're not that good, so I understand.
They're a rival.
Yeah.
I guess our Mallory didn't. Well, second place.
Second place.
Second is best.
King Arturius probably would have been my second choice. Prospector Zeke is always losing stuff, so like I would be like, oh, hey, you can't help me because you can't find your snowballs. Put them together. I don't know. He wouldn't be my favorite pick.
All right, another question?
Yeah, they seem to have this all in hand. We're
Excellent.
Good.
Thank
We're
you,
good.
Community.
I'll go ahead and give some buffs. Oh, wait, I don't have any. Well, the best thing I can do, what do we have? We have life, myth. I'll shield. actually. That'll be more useful. Oh, Victoria Thundershard, who is down on him.
Carl asks, I'm loving the backpack, Butler. Any chance we could get one for an entire account would make it would make so life so much easier, especially for Pat and Mount collectors.
Mm-hmm.
Collectors, that's interesting they mention it.
Mm-hmm.
Considering most of us have those spread out through different wizards.
So, we get you. We really do. Because, you know, there's a lot of... We're hoarders as well. I was making fun of you, but I have a lot of stuff. You know, after 11 years, you have a lot of stuff in game. The one thing I will say is that is much more challenging technically, because on my, say, balance wizard, my balance wizard knows all the things that I have in all the places. But we know that. We're able to call that up really easily. My balance wizard doesn't know what my death wizard has until my death wizard logs in and my balance wizard logs out. So it's not to say that it's an impossibility
Thank
to do
you so
ever.
Much.
I'll never say never.
I hate to ask more of you, but we've really messed up. Please, Sion, you have to help us.
I can't tell again.
Okay, I think we're good. Never say never, but it's not something that's going to come out tomorrow. It would be really, really hard for us to do. A lot of technology changes would have to happen.
This is all my fault!
Ben stormed us.
Well, I guess technically starting an unauthorized alchemy club was Meissen's fault, but whatever.
Pelgrim's sparkle pants.
But whatever.
When Professor Hargrove became suspicious we'd started a club, I panicked and poured all of our alchemy experiments down into the drains. We were just having one last meeting to formally disband. Honest! But before we could adjourn, trash monsters crawled out of the pipes! We tried to reverse the spell, but that just congealed them into one hideous trash king! It chased my friends that way! Please, help them!
Okay. We'll do this one last fight.
We have another tip here. Ben stormed us. Don't be afraid to use team up if you have to. Having even just one additional teammate by your side.
Sorry.
We know it was a mistake.
It just did this.
It just alchemy yeah. without proper supervision. But ever since Madam Dark Kettle.
No, fool! Your mistake was your wastefulness. You spend your lives on a wanton quest for stuff, only to toss it all aside for something shinier.
I love his pizza teeth.
Huh?
You even blithely throw away your own creations if they don't suit you. No, you and all of Wizard City will suffer the wrath of the dis-
Ah! We're so sorry for being wasteful, oh pungent one. And we're really sorry we created you. Please don't hurt us.
Holy crow! It's Bartleby Sion! What are you doing here?
Oh my goodness. Did you come to join the Alchemy Club?
Silence! Your king did not come here to banter. I am here to throw you out!
Our writers are fantastic. Mm-hmm.
This is the
them.
Last battle?
Yeah, this is the last
battle.
It's
going to take you a long time, though, so I
is it?
Not.
Oh, well, we jumped in.
Can we have the community finish it for us, or is that going to...
Well, we jumped in. Let's see what... Oh, it's like 50,000 hit points.
It's going to take a while.
Well, what we can do is we can
probably, leave it.
We can minimize. I might be jumped in and not participating here. We'll give it a round or two.
All right, let's
well,
see.
While we finish the questions.
All right, well, I have a tip actually from Ben Stormdust. Don't be afraid to use the team
Sorry,
if you have to.
Sorry, I interrupted you twice.
Having even just one additional teammate by your side can make things move along much more smoothly. Indeed.
Uh oh, he's gritting.
Oh, let's see how much he can. Well, that's not too bad. Angela Shadowgarden also says decathlons benefit from pets with may cast talents.
Oh yeah, this is a good one.
There are many to choose from, but some cast more than others. Try to utilize spells that are more likely to auto-cast. For example, may cast sword and shield is helpful, but doesn't cast that often.
Yeah, no, that's a really good one. I know there's some people that are working on... Man, I wish I had more buffs for you guys. I'm just deleting all these. Here, I will shield Toria Thundershard. Oh shoot, they're not even using that. Sorry guys, like I said, I'm half paying attention here.
Well, we have one more question for you.
Well, I was going to say, with the Maycast stuff, on the, I am trying to build a pet with as many Maycast heels as possible for the Degathlon Tower in preparation for January. So there's that. But we have one more question.
Joseph asks, how do you pronounce that word?
R-A-T-A-T-O-S-K-R. So I had to go to our writers for this just to make sure. It's Ratatosk, like Bosk. Sam Johnson, our lead creative designer, talked to us, gave me an in-depth lesson about Norse pronunciations. And there's always a silent R.
For fun at the end.
For fun at the end, for no reason. For example, there's a race called the V-A-R-G-R. I actually have this in my notes, so I make sure. So that's why I keep looking down. That everyone called the Varger, but they're actually called the Varg, which is, oh, look, I can actually.
Yeah, we've been in here 5 minutes already. We haven't dented them yet, so yes.
Yeah, we haven't. Sorry, guys. I think I apologize. I think I'm going to have to bail. You guys understand, right?
We can leave it in the background so like, if they want to just continue.
I'll leave it in the background. If I'm defeated, just let me go. Try to keep yourself.
Well, that was all our wizard gameplay tips and questions. Oh. Thank you for everyone for submitting.
Sorry, yeah. let me finish. Where was I? Everyone called them the Varger, but they're actually the Varg, and that's incidentally where Tolkien got the idea for the Warg.
Oh.
So, fun fact from Sam Johnson. Every time I talk to the writers, I swear I learn something new.
If your question or tip was not included in this live stream, don't worry, just submit it again for the next KI Live and the next one after that. If you really want it answered, eventually it will be answered. We just get so many that we have to be selective.
Indeed.
I'll go back to my favorite holiday pet. I thought about it a while.
Yeah?
Lump of coal.
Lump of coal.
That's okay. All right. That's a good one.
Lump of coal.
All right, should we switch over to Pirate here?
Yeah, we'll switch over to Pirate. I think we're already logged
in. And there we are in Pirate here.
So, who's playing? Is it me? Come on, guys.
Yeah, I want to see you play.
Come on, guys. I tell you what.
39% of the vote.
Yeah, I'm turning on the music for Pirate.
Yeah, sometimes you want to win a vote, and sometimes you don't want to win.
Let us know if it's too loud, or you can't hear anything.
Okay, so I'm going to run myself over to ship.
Meanwhile, I have some gameplay tips that I want to launch into these right away.
Please do. We don't have any dialogue here, so please just fire it off.
Captain
fire it off West. Across the bow.
Captain Logan West has fired shots here. Make sure to have a healing companion in your team for fights such as Bonnie Ann.
Yeah.
Bonnie Ann, one of our new friends.
Bonnie Ann is always my first one.
Not just the best sharpshooter with the game. Music.
Really loud.
What happened?
Alright.
Thank you guys for letting us know.
Yep. Alright.
So she's a great sharpshooter, but also a pretty good healer as well. And mainly thanks to her second team.
Oh yeah. That is. She is part of my crew all the time. All right, guys.
Sound effects are still really high.
Still really high?
Really high?
This is a feature of KI Lives. This is just what it is.
Oh, hey, look at that.
I can't hear anything on these.
Sound effects. Okay. Music down.
Bring music all the way down. Bring effects almost all the way down.
All right.
Well, you should keep just a master. Anyways.
Okay. We'll give that a try. Let us know. Come on, retry. Let's do this. Okay, so I'm set up. It's been a while since I played some ship PvP, so this is gonna be really easy. Wait, what is wrong with my horn and my figurehead? Hold on. Okay. This is not good. I need to figure out why I don't have... What's going on?
Yay, we got it.
Cool. Well, I'm going to sail over here. Hopefully nobody defeats me. I'm going to figure out what the heck is going on. No, 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 no. Go, go, go. Go, go, go. Okay. I'm running you guys. I'm just trying to get you. No. Oh, somebody said let's get the boss in the middle. That's pretty cool. That's a good idea. Oh man. Okay, I need to mark myself where I'm right next, so I don't have to keep running back.
We have another tip here from Arden Moonblood.
Yeah, give him the tips. This is just sad.
That's another good one here. Make sure to check the ship emblem vendor in the bazaar. He always brings new ship flag designs for Yuletide.
Okay, why?
The season that you can change your ship's flags to look to. So keep watch for that. Those do rotate in and out.
I'm not sure what's going on here. Why are... Is that not working? This was all working earlier. What do we got here? Like, this should be... I don't know what happened. I used to have everything
unequipped.
Yeah, but it's not like applying. That's weird. All right, guys. No time to figure out what's going wrong. I'll just provide a very, very easy target.
After our Pirate 101 gameplay here, we have also the giveaway code for all of you, and it's a little bit of a gift here. I won't give away the details, but it's a bunch of nice items in both Wizard 101 and Pirate 101. It's a nice end of year gift. Some useful
holiday
things.
Stuff.
Yeah, some holiday stuff.
Oh man, if I go in here, it's gonna be quick. It's gonna be quick, you guys. Oh, I didn't mark either. I have to run back again. I don't even know if it's there's a point. All right. Repair my ship. Oh, don't repair my ship. It's full. Okay, good.
Whoa.
Oh, hey, there we go. Okay. I don't know why my... Oh, probably because I wasn't in range of anybody. Durr.
I'll use the bracket key to target you.
Well, that was quick. That was quick. Okay, I'm gonna run back. I think they voted for me because they think I'd be the worst.
They like the color of your ship.
No, I think they just thought that I'd be the worst at it. Odysseus, you were second place.
Yeah.
Let me go get defeated one more time, and then we'll have you sit down and.
Yes, there will be another holiday contest this year, so stay tuned for all the holiday things.
Yes.
Don't forget the mark.
Yeah, I want to get close there. Okay, I'm going to put my mouse over the mark so that I make sure and...
How's Twitter's doing over there?
Okay, there we go.
Excellent.
Marked.
I have another tip here from Amy. Don't be afraid to ask other players if you have a gameplay question. Most players are more than happy to help, and it's much easier than muddling your way through things. I agree. If you're going to spend 3 or 4 hours and you're just getting frustrated and you don't know how to get through to something, ask other people. I always usually include, there's always a question like that, and I like mentioning those because it's always a nice reminder.
Absolutely.
It's simple but important.
Okay. Let's see. Come on. Since I'm not sitting directly over the mouse, or over the keyboard, I'm using my mouse instead of 1, 2, 3, 4 on these, so.
No, this is
8 hit points. Oh, no.
You're done.
I'm done. Odysseus.
We've had this past year.
I won't make you run.
We've had a couple of XP battles, and I want to bring those back as well. Well, continue them. Oh, are we changing helms?
I'm gonna
let him. Okay. The confidence escalates. Let's see what you can do.
Did you ever fix the abilities?
I did. Okay. It's not that they... I was just having a moment. I wasn't in range of anybody.
Oh. Well, look at all these people just waiting for us.
Mm-hmm. To see if you can take out one of them.
Yeah. We'll just do the tactic where you just sit here, and then once they cross over... You know.
If any of you... If any of you knew me, you'd know that I'm not very good at PvP games or anything PvP. I like playing with people, not against people.
Okay, that's cheesy. I'm gonna cheat.
You're gonna cheat?
Or not. Okay.
That always takes a minute.
Well, sorry about that, guys.
we have a question.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. One more question.
Willow Dream, considering both of the newest Obsidian bosses, Verminius Blightbeard and Black Annie Rackham, have been soloed, I believe, quite difficult without certain setups. Mm-hmm. How difficult were those two fights meant to be?
So we always know that our awesome community out there is going to find ways to do things that we don't expect. Aw, you got defeated.
It's okay. I'll do it again for real.
Okay. But for the average pirate out there, we're intending it to be a group, something that a group can complete with a full group at, you know, level 70. So we know people, we know really good people, really good pirates, really dedicated seasoned pirates are going to figure out ways to solo it or duo it, but most people probably won't be able to.
It's not how it was intended, though. It's supposed to be for a group.
Mm-hmm. So there you go.
And I think Black Anne is supposed to be much harder, actually.
Oh, really?
Black Annie Rackham?
Black Annie Rackham's supposed to be much harder.
They're both pretty challenging, but...
Well, we are coming up on the end of our show here, so you have one chance to show the community that you can win. Good luck. Good luck, sir.
Get him. Get somebody. Get one person.
Well, since we have 3-on-1
That's
here.
That's true. Yeah, probably not going to happen.
Oh. Now 4-on-1.
Oh, no. Where's our team?
Nope.
I'm out. Nope.
Wait.
Somebody's
down.
Well, I hope that was entertaining for all of you. Thanks for...
Hope y'all enjoyed defeating me and then Decius, because I just needed some help.
I'll play my character
Thank
next
you, Decius.
Time.
Next
oh,
time.
Oh, gonna bring out the big guns. Okay,
all right. I'll play my character next time.
All right, looking forward to that. All right, I actually have a few screenshots that I'd like to get through.
Yes, please.
I really wanted to show these off, so let's switch over to those right away.
Let's make it happen.
I am going to mute the audio here just to make sure that's not in the way.
Oh, did we have the wizard audio on too?
I turned that off.
Okay, thank you.
I think. I'm pretty sure I did. Let's actually double check that.
Oh, hey, we're there we go. Oh, they're still going.
Oh, we're still winning. What do we
have? Hold on, let me, I still have some health.
And back to Wizard to see where we're at here.
Let me see if I can, if there's a buff or something that I can give people. Wait, where's my mouse? There's my mouse.
Yes, you can play both games at the exact same time.
I believe it's, CSR feature.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
You can't actually do that.
Oh, you can't? No. Never mind.
Yeah, no. You.
Well, two computers next to each other. That's what I have at home.
Yeah, no. Sorry, guys. Like I said, they're doing good, though. They're all pretty full on health. Like I said, let me die. Let me get defeated. That's totally fine. Beast Moon Myrmidian.
They kept you alive. Yes,
they did. They didn't have to.
Barely.
I told them not to worry about me. That I would be fine. Look at Nice job. Hey, we tuned in just in time to see him defeat the trash monster, or the trash boss. King Detrius.
Ooh.
Krulu! It's like they were just waiting for us to, you know, come back to this so that they could have a really dramatic defeat. Oh man, there's one. Okay, there's one left. All right, guys. I'm gonna cast my Scion of Balance, even though I haven't done much else this fight. Since I got a bunch of pips. Nope, I'm not gonna do that at all.
Nope, fizzle.
They're gonna get it. Somebody's gonna get it. Come on, Headless Horseman. Horseman. I believe in you. I believe in you, Headless Horseman. There we go.
Yay.
Boom, done.
And shrivels up. Victory.
Yay, you did it. We're saved. Thank you so much. Oh, wait. We don't have a view. Do you think we could Photomance a quick selfie?
Your heroics make it even harder to break it to you that we've decided to disband the Alchemy Club. I'm so sorry, your sinus.
I think they'll live, Mycin. More importantly, we need to get the book back to the library before important people start connecting dots.
We stole an alchemy book, not a connect the dots book, ya goof.
I almost said sigh. You've already done so much, but can you please return the alchemy book to the library? If we're caught with it, we'll be expelled.
It goes in the forbidden magic section. Argelstone will show you where. Wait, don't ask him. You'll figure it out. You're the scion. Thanks.
And there we go.
All right.
Thank you to everybody. We have Victoria Thundershard, Alexander L., and Valerian. I can't see the name.
Valerian Drake.
Thank you guys for carrying me through this wonderful first part of Wizard City Underground and saving the epic defeat until we tune back in. So.
And it was epic indeed.
Yes.
Very, very good. Well done there.
Yes. Good job, you guys.
All right. We have some festive holiday screenshots to show all of you here. So thank you, everybody, again in-game. We're going to switch over to our screenshots.
Yeah, let's check out the screenshots. They've been going in the background, and I can't wait to show them to you guys because they're so good this time.
They're so good.
And those were great. Another peek at that one.
Yeah, we're not talking about that one yet.
All right. Here is one from Amanda
Iceblade. I will say by the next time we do KI Live, they'll know what that is.
Oh, yeah.
So there we go.
Excellent.
There we go.
So not too long to wait. Okay, good. Amanda Iceblade, happy early holiday and Christmas, everyone.
Yay.
Here's one from Ashley Dragon Tamer, inviting everyone to spend Christmas with her and her Christmas Gracie in Marleybone.
I know there's somebody who appreciates that in this room. Yeah.
I appreciate all moose.
Here's one from Autumn Iceflower, hanging out with her favorite pals for Christmas.
Aw, very nice.
Christina Lion Rider launching off the Christmas season with style.
The bunny sleigh.
Here's Isaiah I misspelled that. Hex Rider and Austin Winter Gem.
Very cool. Very nice.
A bit of photomancy there.
Yeah.
And Maddie and Moria celebrating the holidays by visiting our favorite polar bear to drink some root beer and eat some cookies.
Very nice.
That's my favorite. Drinking some root beer and eating some cookies.
Mm-hmm.
Especially the cookies.
Yes. What about ice cream?
And ice cream. Oh, yes, of course. How could I forget that?
Yeah.
Mariah Stormheart and Madeline's son. What better way to celebrate the holidays than a visit to Santa?
Aww.
You can't see it in the picture, but the presents float and dance.
How cool. I love castle magic. I love castle magic. It's so cool.
My name is Elizabeth Winterstone, and this shows how much I love Christmas and my specialty in ice school. Snowball fights for everyone!
Very nice.
And Nicholas Owl, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Old picture of one of my old houses with lots of snow globes in it.
Oh,
so I guess that's what happens when
snowy.
You have a lot of snow.
Snowy
globes.
And fiery at the same time. I like it.
Yeah.
I like it a lot.
Excellent.
Hey, speaking of snowball fights.
Yeah.
Do we still have King Arturius in the lead?
Let's see. Yes,
he officially won because the poll ended with 40%.
40% for King Arcturus.
Sorry, that was probably supposed to be bigger reveal later. I'm like, wait, snowballs. Let's talk about that.
And here in Pirate 101, Christina Jellicoe, we pirates love to celebrate Christmas in big ways. And there's her ship in the background.
I love it. And yes, go, not yet, but soon, go check out the vendor and get yourself some holiday sales.
And I think one more, I believe. And also in Pirate 101, Merry Christmas from Merciless Antonio Xavier and the Spirits of Yuletide.
Very cool.
And this
one more.
Scarlet Winterheart.
The Winter Treant.
And her group here off to some grand adventure. And more. Victoria Thunderstar.
And wait, there's more.
There's more. I thought that I had the Pirate 101s in one section. Victoria Thunderstar says, hanging out at the Spiral Vision Santa Run from last year.
That's so cool. There's so many people. I hope there's another. That's so awesome.
Let me know, community, if there's a Spiral Vision Santa Run for this year. I don't know if I've seen any news for it, but we'll have, like I mentioned earlier, we're going to have one more newsletter for Wizard and Pirate.
Mm-hmm.
That will be the combination of December and January, and I'm collecting all of the community news for it. So if you have upcoming events throughout the holidays, contests, in-game adventures, that sort of thing, let me know, and I will include it in that newsletter.
For sure.
And let's see if we have more.
Is there more?
Nope,
that's it. That's a great one, Ned. That's so cool. I love it.
Thank you, everybody, for joining us. We really appreciate it.
Yes, thank you.
I'm not going to forget the giveaway code.
No, we're doing that still.
What, we're giving away code?
What?
Yeah, I thought.
Nah,
you know,
it's okay. We're done.
I mean, we don't have to.
All right, thanks, everybody. We'll see you next year. Oh, wait. No.
Okay, well, this there's a lot of good pet snacks in this one. There's some housing items. There's, in the case of Pirate, at least, there's a pet. So some really good stuff here. I don't have a complete list.
There's actually a big, like, I saw the big bullet point list for each.
Yeah.
For each
and
game.
Since
yeah.
it's not random, you'll get what you get. So somebody can post it in a screenshot or what have you of what you get when
there's
you redeem the
stuff.
Code
stuff.
For each game. So as a reminder, also, when this goes on YouTube, probably tomorrow, we'll open the giveaway window up again for 1,000 additional codes. So there's always another opportunity. You don't have to run and grab it, although we are running a little bit ahead of behind time here. So when I mention the code here, you have about 20 minutes from this moment to redeem it. So you have some time.
Tick-tock, guys.
And the code is KI presents 2019. Wait, not presents. Presence. Presence. Doesn't matter.
It's KI presents.
It's spelled the same.
KIPRESENTS 2019. I can do it, guys.
KI presents.
KI presents.
2019.
KI presents. 2019. The year of awesomeness.
And I think we'll get that on Twitter. And
yes.
Okay, excellent.
Awesome.
Well, thanks to Kaylee for all of the tweets. If you're following Twitter,
yay!
We really appreciate everything that you community have done this year. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Deezy, as always, for your monthly help with the KI Lives.
Mm-hmm.
And for everybody else who helps with these, and including the community
and
the chat.
And we thank you guys for tuning in, for being awesome, for just making it so fantastic to work on Wizard 101 and Pirate 101 and be part of the MMO community here.
Yeah, it's great. And
we love it.
We have more, so stay tuned for a very cool 2020.
Yes, we'll be very excited to get things rolling again in 2020, talk about some new stuff. We got a lot coming up in January, actually.
It's a lot, yeah.
I could talk about it, but yeah, we've gone on
too
long. We'll talk about that. We'll do that next time.
Happy holidays, everyone.
Happy holiday. Have a safe and happy and warm holiday to you and yours from us and ours. We love y'all.